back with a vengeance in the Middle East, and the world is taking notice. No, we're not talking about the ancient Egyptian goddess, but this jihadist group is trying to restore an ancient system of its own. ISIS stands for the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. Their goal goes back to the Prophet Muhammad, establish a far-reaching Islamic state called a caliphate. For ISIS, Iraq and Syria are just the beginning. Their territory is roughly the size of Belgium right now. But where did they come from? ISIS used to be called Al-Qaeda in Iraq, or AQI. Though Sunni, they became known in the country during the Iraq War for their extremism, including oppression of women and vicious strikes against civilians. U.S. troops and allied Sunni militias conquered them during the post-2006 surge, but ISIS wasn't fully destroyed. So in 2011, when a large number of Al-Qaeda prisoners were released from jail, ISIS began rebuilding its power. In February 2014, ISIS and Al-Qaeda broke off their relationship. ISIS was essentially too extreme, even for Al-Qaeda. They now fight against each other for power over Islamist extremist groups around the globe. They only have about 7,000 troops at most at their disposal. But in June, ISIS captured control of Mosul, Iraq's biggest city, though they've since been pushed back by U.S. airstrikes. And they're not short on cash, with an estimated $2 billion war chest by a variety of kidnapping, oil field, and extortion rackets. Of course, ISIS has most recently made news for publishing brutal videos showing their beheadings of American and British journalists. They are not going to back down quietly. For now, their foes in the Middle East are digging in, and opponents of extremism everywhere should hope that they can win out. I'm Gabrielle Tudin, and this is Fusion.